fashion.
Let's go. Hey. Play back.
Come on.
Welcome to my first video shoot.
Come on.
Okay. For those that don't know, I had a budding music career as a rapper. Didn't last long, but I did make a video, and on the video set is where I first met Vanessa.
I see the lovely young ladies that I haven't even met yet. How you doing?
Hi,
Kobe.
Nice to meet you. Trinidad.
Trinidad, how you doing? Thomasina. How you doing, Thomasina? What's your name?
Vanessa.
Vanessa, how you doing?
Hi.
Pleasure. I wasn't some big time basketball player at the time either, so it was like, you know, it's a pleasure to meet you. It was a 2-day video shoot, and I was always looking for her. Like, I wanted to know where she was, and I would finish a take and then go to my trailer, but I wonder where she is the entire time, and then come out of the trailer and just want to talk to her some more in between takes and stuff like that. And she wrote a phone number down at the time where you had to still write phone numbers down. And I called her the very next day, and we talked for hours.
So, Vanessa,
she was just beautiful. We literally did everything together. Everything together. And I thought I was a big dork because I loved Disneyland. I loved the Disney movies and things like that, but I never really had a chance to go to the park much. And she was a big Disney fan too. And we used to hang out at Disneyland. We used to go to Magic Mountain. She became my best friend, you know? And for me, it was very different to have somebody that I was so close to, because I had been so used to growing up in isolation, really, and moving around from place to place and making new friends all the time. So I never really opened up to anybody because I knew I was just going to inevitably move. But now, you know, being in Los Angeles and feeling like I'm going to be a Laker for the rest of my life, and I just met this beautiful woman that I just see the world the same way with. We decided to get married. I proposed. She said yes. We're both so young, right? So I'd wake up and I'd go train and I'd come back and she'd still be in the bed sleeping like 18-year-olds do, man. She'd be asleep till like 12, 1 o'clock in the afternoon, man. And then I lay down with her and I'd go to sleep again too. And then, you know, we'd wake up and just, you know, do what kids do. Do what kids do. I'd take her to the batting cage. We'd go hit some balls. Like, and we'd play miniature golf. You know, we'd go to the movies. We'd go out to eat. It was a beautiful time, man. When we had Natalia, it was like such a beautiful moment. You know, because we were starting our own family. And I found so much enjoyment in just being with our baby girl. You know, it was great. And you putting together the nursery and, you know, the crib and all those weird baby Einstein, baby Mozart videos where you're kind of just hypnotizing your kid. Like, we went through all of that stuff. And when you're young, you really have the tendency to think about your own personal journey. And for us, it was about taking two young people and trying to figure out our journey together and try to grow together, which is a challenge. But when you have a kid, then it becomes even bigger than that, because now you have responsibility of this little life that you have to mold.